Welcome to Bobcats Weekly, the place for all the latest on your favorite Quinnipiac teams. I'm your host, Nolan Rich. QU women's basketball had a busy week with three games, including an appearance in the TD Bank Classic. But first, they would have to defend their home court versus another mid-major power. Women's basketball battling Temple. A battle of defenses in this one early on. Well, the Bobcats will swing this ball to Adele Thorne, and she hits the three. She had 8 points in this one. Later on, it's Katie Carroll from behind the arc with the bucket and the swish. This would end up with a wild finish in this one. Bobcats with a two-point lead. Temple will throw it up. Their defense, though, would hold tough. Temple's going to kick it out for the three after this missed layup, trying for the desperation shot as time is winding down. Temple trying to get the win. No good as the Bobcats will hold on to this one. The buzzer sounds. And the Bobcats walk out of the TD Bank Sports Arena with a 58-56 win. Napolitano leads the Bobcats with 12 points, while Sarah Schuen leads QU with 7 rebounds and 3 blocks. After an 8-6 loss to Georgetown, Bobcats finishing up the TD Bank Classic. Quinnipiac battling Vermont. I don't know about you, but give the ball to 22. Brittany Johnson with the layup for Quinnipiac. Then again, give her the rock with another bucket. She had 10 points. Later on, Brittany Martin, Swish City for the three. Then here's a head fake and a drive by Martucci. Whoop! Going in for the layup. Bobcats would end the weekend with a big road win, beating the Catamounts by the final score of 77-65. Maria Napolitano ties a career high in this game with 20 points, while Brittany Johnson has a career high day as well with 10 points. While the women's team picked up two big wins this week, the Quinnipiac men's basketball team hosted two home games of their own as they get into the heart of their season. First up would be NC Central. Bobcats looking for back-to-back home wins in the corner. It's Giovanni McLean pulling a little shake and fake right here as he pulls up for the three-pointer and finds nothing but net, as this would be a good shot for him. Bobcats would go on a 22-2 run in the second half as the offense would be rolling as Abdullah Bundu drives inside for two. Quinnipiac dominating the paint, and later it's Chase Daniels working hard down low for 2 points. Daniels with 16. Second straight game for Daniels where he leads the Bobcats in scoring. And then later on, he's going to show off the outside range right here, showing that he can go outside the paint and do some work as the Bobcats would hold on to win this one by the final score 69-59. Daniel Harris leading QU with 10 boards. Men's basketball hosting Albany in the second game of the week as Samuel Dingba, as you what you can say is bada bing, bada boom, baby, at the top of the key with 6 points in this one. There on, it's Abdullah Bundu showing how to dominate in the paint. This kid is how you dominate down low as he goes inside with the one-hander for the bucket. McLean would then later give it to Harris on the outside as he would pull up the head fake, whoop, go back to the outside, and then the fadeaway jumper for the bucket. Bobcats would not be able to hold this one as Harris, even with 19 points, as the Bobcats would fall in the second half and would fail to capitalize on their first set lead as they fall to UAlbany in this one by the final score of 58-54, as Daniel Harris once again leads the Bobcats with 19 points. Coming up next on Bobcats Weekly, Alexa Farrell sits down in studio with one of the leaders for the women's basketball team. And later, men's ice hockey would look to remain undefeated while the women battle for in-state bragging rights. All this and much more next on Bobcats Weekly.
You don't see the practice.
You don't see the early mornings.
The late nights.
You don't see the blood.
The blood.
The blood.
The blood.
The sweat.
The tears.
You don't see the game before the game.
It's game day.
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 Hello and welcome to Bobcats Weekly. I'm Alexa Farrell. Each week we welcome in a Quinnipiac athlete to chat with us about their season. And this week we welcome in one of the leaders of the QU women's basketball team, Adelie Martucci. Adelie, thanks for joining us today.
Thank you for having me.
So you're the captain of the women's basketball team this year, and you lost a lot of seniors last year. So what has it been like stepping into that leadership position?
It's definitely a huge change. Them leaving has given an opportunity for a lot of people on this team to really step up, including myself, Maria being another captain, Carly and Katie. So it's definitely different.
And how's your season been going so far?
It's going really good. We're 4-2, so it's a winning season so far, and it's good to start off that way.
Great. Well, good luck with the rest of the season, and I wish you guys the best of luck.
Thank you very much.
When we come back, we look to see if the men's hockey team can keep their unbeaten season alive, while the women's team faced a couple of in-state foes. Stay tuned to Bobcats Weekly.
Welcome back to the Bobcats Weekly Studio. I'm Nolan Rich. The Quinnipiac men's ice hockey team still has not lost a game this season. But if they wanted to keep their undefeated streak alive, they would have to deal with a weekend series against UMass. In the first game, Bobcats would score a huge road win over the Minutemen. By the final, 4-1, Sam Annis with a goal and two assists, and Travis St. Dennis would also add two assists in the road win. Bobcats looking for the clean sweep as they brought it back to Connecticut. Michael Gartig looking to keep his recent hot streak and goal going. In the first period, Tim Clifton will pick this puck up in the corner, throws it to the front of the net, and it's deflected in by Scott Davidson for the goal. 1-0 Bobcats in the first period. Then later in the second period, Travis St. Dennis with the breakaway. He's going to try for the goal, but he gets tripped up. Would lead to a penalty shot. He would not be able to get it. But then Gartig with a big save here. Loose puck in foot, but Bo Pieper, kick save and a beauty. Doing his best goaltender impression there. As the Bobcats hold on to win this one by the final of 1-0, keeping their undefeated season alive. Gartig ties the program record for wins with his 59th career win as he earns his fifth shutout this season. Quinnipiac women's ice hockey was looking for their third consecutive Nutmeg Classic title. Bobcats would head to Ingalls Rink for the tournament hosted by Yale University. Q looking for state bragging rights, opening up against UConn in the first period. It would be Nicole Costa. She gets this puck on the top of the circle and blasts it into the back of the net for the goal. 1-0 Bobcats. And from there, it would be the Sydney Rossman show, as Sydney Rossman coming up big with 16 saves in this one as she earns her third consecutive shutout. As even though UConn pulls the goalie at the end, Bobcats would hold on for the 1-0 victory and would go to the Nutmeg Finals on Sunday against Yale as they take on their arch rivals. Picking up the action in the second period, Melissa Samuskevich will come along the boards and she will find TT Cianfrall streaking down the middle of the ice. Cianfrall driving the zone. She's going to pull up, fire, and score her 15th of the season. And she puts the Bobcats up 1-0 in this one. Later on in the third period, it would be a battle in the corner as Nicole Connery trying to push this one in the front of the net. She gives it to Cianfrall. Puck is loose in front, and it's Connery through the 5-0 with the goal. Bobcats up 2-0. Yale would pull the goalie late, trying to get back into this one, but the Bobcats would ice the game right here. Empty netter puts this away, and the Bobcats earn their third consecutive Nutmeg Classic title. TT Cianfrall earns the tournament MVP, while Sydney Rossman picks up her fourth consecutive shutout and the tournament's most valuable goaltender. This week's play of the week goes to Nicole Costa, who snipes the shot in from the top of the circle. Costa's goal would be the game winner against UConn, and she earns this week's play of the week. That's going to do it for this episode of Bobcats Weekly. Miss part of the show or want to watch it again? You can always watch us at QU Athletics on YouTube. And remember, Bobcat fans, you can follow your favorite Quinnipiac teams all season long on QuinnipiacBobcats.com. Thanks for joining us. I'm Nolan Rich, and we'll see you next time.